God bless everyone.
Hello, everyone. God bless you.
We're going to take the time to set the atmosphere. Hallelujah. We're going to take the time to set the atmosphere. God bless you, woman of God. How are you?
God bless you. God bless you, too.
God bless you. Hakarababasia. We've been seeing some very normal supernatural stuff. I'm going to say it like this. Everybody needs to understand that the lifestyle of the supernatural can be just the way things are in your life. Your normal has to be different from everybody else's because you are created by God. But this is the thing, as a born-again believer, born from above, you now have the ability to walk as a son and a daughter of God here on earth. Now, we're telling you this on the backdrop of everything that is happening right now. This is not a ploy to give you words of encouragement with no substance. You need to understand that. Everything we're talking about tonight has spiritual significance, and it always does when we get on the line. So before we go into what we want to talk about tonight, it's going to be important that because we're prophetic in nature and we operate in the office of a prophet as well as apostle and everything else like that, you need to understand that people need to learn how to hear and to discern the voice of God. There's lots of people that are confused as to what the voice of God is, and God is not the author of that. And what God has been doing with a lot of people, it's been training them how to lead them by the Spirit. And if you do not know the voice of God for yourself, what will eventually happen? God bless you. God bless you. Son Eugene, he just made it on. God bless you. Hallelujah. We want to make sure that everybody's in connection tonight. Now, again, if you do not know the voice of God, somebody else will determine that for you. It's not to say that you don't need people in your life to help confirm what is going on. Apostle Young did not say that. But many people, when they're trying to hear the voice of God, you have to learn somewhere. And many times you may find yourself in situations where you're actually hearing from God and somebody's telling you that you're not. I have been down that road. I had somebody tell me that I lost my mind, but still wanted me in my position, which brings me to another point. Many times people will put you in positions to keep you in bondage. And don't think that does not happen, because it does. You have to understand that you have, in a time of crisis, the decisions that you make are very important. They have life-changing and life-preservation significance. Now, again, we want to make sure you understand this again. I used this in the last segment, and we're going to make sure we do this one more time so you get the message. This symbolizes the will of God in your life. When you're in the will of God, you are covered by this. Now, we've got this open in the house. We're not superstitious. We're not thinking about any curse. The devil is a lie. So, but for those that are superstitious, we're believers. We're not under any of that. So I want you to understand that when you're out in the elements, it's going to rain or the sun's going to shine anyway. This umbrella is there to protect you, because this is the thing. As a believer,
from the elements,
as a believer, you're going to deal with problems anyway because you're in the will of God. But being in the will of God, you're under God's divine protection.
His covering. Amen.
That's very important. All right, you can put exhibit A now. So it's important to understand that the will of God is your protection. Why are we saying this? You're going to go through a place where God is going to have to lead you by his Spirit. And when he's leading you by his Spirit, he is directing you into the will of God for your life. If you do not know the will of God for your life, somebody else is going to try to direct you in what their perception is. Because I'd have been down that road. What we do on what we do on Zoomcast and on YouTube and when we go out is to bring in awareness of what God wants to do in your life. We want to set you free from bondage. I think that's important. But there's lots of people that seem like they love bondage. I mean, they love to be controlled. They love to be put in the corner somewhere. And many people are stagnated and don't even know what their calling is, not walking in things. I know of ministers that have to, I'm gonna say this in a way that you can get my point. Can I please go to the bathroom? I mean, listen, that's how ridiculous it is. I mean, people can't even go out and evangelize unless they get permission. But that is the mandate. This is one of the reasons why God shut some of this stuff down, because we've had more of a church perspective and a bondage perspective rather than a kingdom perspective. So you have to understand that if you're a citizen of the kingdom that we talk about, if you are born again, you have to be able at some point be able to know the voice of God. Because Brenda and I deal with people from time to time. They're confused. They're trying to hear God, but you need to have a compass. Now, part of our job is to confirm what God is doing in your life, not to dispute it, to help you get to a place where you can hear God. That's important, because you're going to have to be able to navigate through life right now the way it is, knowing that God is leading you by your spirit. Anything that happens within the setting that we're doing right now is just there to bring in awareness and to confirm and to activate the voice of God in your life. We want God to be able to visit you in a very powerful way, that way you can know what is going on. So this is the thing that this has to be a lifestyle. So the last time that we came together, we talked about the importance of praying without ceasing and why that is necessary. The scripture tells us to pray without ceasing. Why is it necessary? Because there's always something going on in the spirit realm. There's always something going on in the heavenly realm, the realm that you do not see. And when we're praying without ceasing, we're activating activity for us to be a partaker of. Many times people miss the move of God because they're not in tune with what is happening. That's why the prophetic voice, and not just our prophetic voice, there's other prophetic voices out there, people that can hear from God. That's why the prophetic voice is necessary and the prophetic anointing is necessary for you to be activated in a deeper sensitivity in a realm of the spirit, because you're going to have to be sensitive amidst all the noise, amidst all of the confusion, and we're going to address this in a minute. With all of the stuff that's happening with the violence and the stuff that's been going on in this world, one of the things that the Lord has stressed for me to do is talk about the power of God. The power of God brings you in a state of awareness in spite of everything that's going on, to help you, to remind you of just how powerful God is in the midst of everything that's going on. Because we realize that violence of any kind, we realize that sickness of any kind ultimately has its origins from the powers of hell. And the power of God will help you navigate through all of this and to walk in these things. Because this is the thing that we have to address real quick. There's lots of people that even with the coronavirus have said that it was a hoax, but some of those people died from it. So again, seriously. So listen, we want you to be in a place that you can navigate through all of this, because whether it goes anywhere or not, you still have to exist from day to day. Does everybody understand that? So there has to be a power greater than anything in this earth for you to be able to walk in. We preach power, we teach and demonstrate power. Faith is activated. Faith comes by hearing. So when you're on this line, we're not going to give you a lot of survival tactics from the standpoint of going somewhere to hide in a cave somewhere. The devil is a lie. You need to know that the Lord had prompted me. You need to know the power and authority that you walk in. You need to do this. And when we go out, we want to make sure that you can feel the presence of God. But it starts with being able to hear the voice of God, because we know people that are struggling with that right now. And again, what you got to understand is that if you do not know the voice of God, you cannot know your purpose. And if you do not know your purpose, somebody else is going to determine what your purpose is. So I want you to keep that in mind tonight. I think that's important.
It's very important. You know, the Bible tells us that in St. John 16, that the Spirit, when he comes, the Spirit of truth, which is the Holy Spirit, mm-hmm. he will lead. He was talking to his disciples, but everything he gave them is false also, because we're disciples of Christ.
Amen.
He said, praise God. Let me read that scripture. Praise the Lord. 13. Let's start.
Okay.
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Okay. No, I'm going to start with 12. I have many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself. Praise the Lord. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come. Amen. So it's God's will to show us, Amen. To tell us things. So that's personal. Personal relationship. That's what relationship is about. Knowing, being told, and know.
Amen.
It's two-way. Amen. So God knows everything, so you can't tell him nothing he don't know. But he wants to give things to us, Amen. So we can know. We need his mind. Amen. And we need to know the things that is to come. And he desires to do that for us. We have to have a relationship that we hear from God. He also says, my sheep hear my voice. And another they shall not follow. Praise God. So when we are in tune with the Lord, we are seeking the Lord, and we have communion with God all the time, we will hear his voice. We will know. We don't have to be in limbo or confused about things over and over and over. We can know what the Lord is saying to us. And actually, his word gives us a lot of things on how to live and what to do. Amen. But there's some gray areas and things we don't know exactly what to do. But in relationship, it's very important, because he will direct us. Amen. And he'll give you something, and then he'll have somebody confirm what he's already told you. That's what I love about it. Amen. Not always looking to someone to tell you what to do, but to get confirmation on what God has already told you. Amen. Because that's the way God wants us to operate. He's Lord. And if he's not Lord, my God, we're in trouble. We need to make him who he is in our life. He is Lord and Savior. Amen. Amen. Lord means Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. He controls. He controls Amen. It all. When we give it to him, we give ourselves to him, he's not going to let us go astray. Amen.
Has anybody that's on the line tonight, or that will be listening to me, have you ever felt God leading you somewhere and you went to get confirmation and they told you that you was not hearing from God? Have you ever had that? I've had that. And believe me, even at the stage that I'm at right now, people still try to tell me what God is saying. And you know, this is the thing that disturbs me about that. I understand that we need confirmation. And believe me, I say this in the context that I do listen to counsel. I want you to understand that I do listen to counsel. But then this is the thing. So I want you, let's be clear on that. I do listen to counsel. Don't think that I'm somewhat, I'm out there wild and stuff like that. But there's times when you know that God has really spoken something to you. And many times God's going to tell you stuff on the backdrop of everything else not looking like it's supposed to be.
Come on.
I mean, so what you have to do is understand the scripture says that his sheep know his voice, and another they will not follow. That means there's other voices that you could potentially listen to. But the whole essence of everything that we do on here is to get you more sensitive to the voice of God in your life. Because remember, I'm talking to leaders on this line. If you do not know the voice of God, you're like the blind leading the blind. And when the blind lead the blind, everybody fall in the ditch. And there's a lot of people in ditches right now because they're following people that don't know God. This is the thing you don't understand. There's people who occupy pulpits that don't know God. Seriously. I mean, in the 30-something years, almost 40 years, I mean, listen, 1983, somewhere in there. In all the years that I've been saved, I've seen that scenario played over and over again. And I feel this in my heart, right? I feel this in my spirit. God is elevating leadership in somebody. All of the criteria that you think that you need, some of it, I'm seriously, you don't need. You need to be led by the Holy Ghost, because if you're led by the Holy Ghost, you got more than a lot of people that have been preaching for 10 and 15 years. Seriously. Because believe this, it's possible for you to preach and teach and not be led. That happens all the time. I feel God's protection over tonight about this, because God wants you in the will of God for your life. And yes, you may start at a specific stage in point, but you're going to grow. The voice of God grows. His ability to speak to you grows with intimacy and in time listening to the voice of God. We're going in this direction tonight because somebody needs this message tonight. Because this is the time that God is birthing the prophetic voice. In a time of crisis, you need to know what thus saith the Lord is for yourself and also for those around you. The very liberating thing is to be able to know what God is doing, because that's when people can get a greater assurance or covering, so to speak, of what is happening. Because if they know what God is doing in their lives, they have a way to be able to navigate. Now, we realize all the time that when we walk in the things of the Spirit, we also have to do that not just for ourselves, but also for the benefit of those around that have been in bondage for a lifetime. Brenda and I know what it is to have been in bondage. And we believe that because we've gone through that, oh my God, God wants to set some people free. God wants to give you your marching orders. You don't have to wait to be discovered by an agent in order for you to go forth in God in this season, because the harvest is already ripe. It's already ripe. And again, when we talk about these things, we would be, like I said, we would do you an injustice not to be able from time to time to give you testimonies of the things that God has done. Now, in the times that we've gone out, we have seen God move. We told you the last time we was together about that precious little girl that every night, to our knowledge, she was waking up crying, and that was the thing that her mother was saying. And what was happening was that this was happening pretty much every night, and this was something that was passed down through the generations.
Her father was
doing the same thing.
That's what his mother told her.
Exactly. So we took the time to pray. Guess what? And I got another one. This is gonna mess you up. We took the time to pray with her. We anointed her, and she felt the peace of God. She held on to pastor real tight at that particular point. We found out when we talked with her the next day that she stayed asleep the whole night. She didn't cry once. And then when we seen her 3 days later, it was the same scenario. Amen. It was the same.
Things are the same.
They're still sleeping good, because that's the type of stuff that we need to do. And yesterday we was out doing a little bit of counseling and stuff like that, and doing some ministry. The precious brother, I'm not going to mention his name, he was dealing with problems in his back. And we just took the time to just speak over his back and pray over his back. And because he was a little bit uncomfortable in the seat because of the pain that he'd been dealing with. After prayer, the pain disappeared. Seriously.
Thank you, Lord.
This is not to give glory to men.
Jesus.
I beg of you.
Amen.
This is about to give glory to God. And today, give him the glory. So we went out to today, right? Check this out. I was out there talking, and I'm going to tell you about another issue that we need to deal with. I was leaving one of my favorite stores, Walmart. So leaving the store, there was a precious lady that was walking in the store. And you know, here in Patterson, Bayou Vista, and stuff like that, you have some people that are that are walking with a certain demeanor. They've got their attire and stuff on. I'm talking about the mask and stuff like that. But she wasn't walking with a mask. I just waved at her and said, God bless you. She said, God bless you back. But I noticed she was walking gingerly on her left foot. And what had happened was, this is funny. She asked her what was wrong with her leg. She said there was something wrong with her ankle. Her left ankle was hurting her. And she was walking on it very gently. And I said, Do you mind if I pray with you? I'm not going to touch you. You know what I mean? Because you have to be careful about social distance and stuff like that. She wasn't worried about this. She said, go ahead and pray. Now, check this out. I took the time to speak over her leg, right, or over her ankle, and commanded it to be healed and stuff like that. Now, mind you, we was in the middle. You know how it is when you go into the parking lot and people make the turn to go in the aisles, the park and stuff like that. We didn't know no better. We was right there in the middle. We was blocking everything. So check this out. She was getting ready to pull. I mean, there was a car that was getting ready to pull in. The lady that was praying for her, she did one of these numbers like this. Stop, we're praying here. She stopped the car right there in front of the store to get prayer. Talk about desperation. So she got prayer right there, right there in front of Walmart and stopped the people right there. And I asked her the question. I said, on a scale of 1 to 10, how do you feel right now? And where's the pain? She looked and she just did one of these takes. You know, the pain is gone. The pain is gone. And she started moving it. And then the people that she had blocked, like a stopping guard and stuff like that, they saw what had happened, right? So they said, oh, you're praying. We need to pray for the world. They was just so happy somebody was praying. I mean, they could have got, I mean, they was precious older ladies. They didn't get out, cuss us out, or anything like that. They was glad that some prayer was going on. But it was a manifestation of the kingdom of God. So she got healed and she thanked me. She hugged me and then she went on the store and I got in the car, mission accomplished.
Praise God.
Why is that relevant? Okay. Because before I left out of the store, there was a gentleman that was in the cereal aisle, back in the cereal aisle. And I took the time to witness to him and ask him. He had been raised in church. He had been raised in church, but he stopped going to church because in his mind, he doesn't feel, why should he pay a man to be able to tell him to live right and do these things? And they're out there doing the same thing or even worse than he is. And he gave an illustration about some ministers in a church that's here locally, that there's a serious situation going on where there's some infidelity and there's a lot of crazy stuff going on. And again, when we was telling him about some of the stuff that the Lord's been doing, it messed him up in a good way because he doesn't have any point of reference for that. And he said he'd given his heart to the Lord. I asked him if he was born again. And he said he's saved, but he doesn't feel the need to go to church because of everything that's been going on. And that scenario is played over, over and over and over again. And we have to do everything within the capacity and the grace that God's given us to be able to point people to Christ in the midst of all this. I told him this before we left. I said, God is always going to have somebody. Amen. That's real. God is always mm-hmm. going to have somebody that's real. And I know the people on this line can bear with it. If you're on this line tonight, I know that, like I said, you need to be real for the Lord because we have to do a lot of damage control. We have to do a lot of damage control. So I think it's important to understand that when we talk about testimonies, people need to get a point of reference. And like the people that are on this line, you've had testimonies of what God has done. That's part of the package. You want to be able to be free, to operate in the things of God, and to manifest the kingdom in a time of crisis. So this is the greatest opportunity for everyone that's on you. And as we get ready to go into the Word, again, I remind you, the reason why Apostle Young preaches and teaches and administers, we believe that we're releasing an anointing. Hallelujah. We're releasing an anointing, an apostolic anointing. I'm a beneficiary of being under that type of anointing. Okay, Rabbi. Okay, somebody, all right. Somebody's having trouble getting on. Hallelujah. I think, all right. Hallelujah. If tell them to try again. And again, like I said, if I see them trying to get on now, the last four digits of the call number, it's going to be 8639. We got more than one. So 86, okay, all right. 86, okay, somebody getting on right now. Okay, all right, cool. All right, 8639 is the last, there's a number that you see. All right, so if you got more than one, all right. If you got more than one, like I said, 8639, you wanna say something? All right, but again, it's important to understand that we want you to be real for the things of God. We're serious about this. It's too late in the game to be playing and shucking and jiving. We need to be real for God. And a person who's not real for God in this season, it can kill a person. If you're not real for God in this season, it can literally kill a person. And because again, you're open to a lot of things when you're not walking, just like that umbrella. Going back to what we said, Jesus said, his sheep know his voice. And those that are led by the Spirit, they're sons of God. So I feel the presence of God tonight to be able to minister life. Now, again, this segment is being recorded, so you'll get a chance to hear it again and again. But we want you to be able to know that testimonies are part of the package. People can argue with you about your doctrine. They can argue with you about your character. You need to make sure you have character, all right? Character is very important. But this is the thing. They can't argue about evidence. They can say it's not real. They can say a lot of things, but nobody can ever argue about evidence. So we're going to tie this together in a nice little bow, like only the Holy Ghost can. Let's go to St. Luke chapter 17. St. Luke chapter 17. We're still dealing with the subject of the kingdom. We're dealing with a situation now where wherever you're listening to me right now, governments have a tendency to are a little bit unstable and they're lacking control. But the kingdom of God is always under control. And there's some things that's supposed to be, brewing in the Gulf right now. We're going to be taking that before the Lord and moving in some authority concerning that. But God's got a sense of humor putting us by the Gulf. So we're going to be in prayer concerning that. But it's important to understand that when we deal with the realm of kingdom is a place of safety. All right. St. Luke chapter 17. And Brenda, they said, read verses 20 and 21.
Okay. 20 and 21. Yeah. Okay. And when he was demanded of the Pharisees when the kingdom of God should come, he answered them and said, the kingdom of God cometh not with observation. Neither shall they say, lo here or lo there. For behold, the kingdom of God is within you. Amen.
And it says, behold or look, recognize. Mm-hmm. The kingdom of God is within you. Now, remember we talked about earlier about people putting you into bondage? One of the benefits of the kingdom of the New Testament believer, the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven and earth resides in you. That means you call yourself an ambassador of the kingdom. You are a conduit and a channel of the kingdom of God here on the earth right now. That is a powerful situation, I'm gonna tell you. How you view life when you leave out your door in the morning and understanding that you have all the attributes of the kingdom on the inside of you. It may be true that you have to grow in the revelation of that. That may be true. But when you understand in the basic concept that the kingdom of God resides in you, you now start the process as a born again believer to walk in the totality of the fullness of the Godhead. Amen. You have the ability to walk in God's power and revelation, and tied within the kingdom is the ability to be able to know God, to be able to know the will of God. Because when we're in the will of God and we walk within kingdom mandate, we walk in God's divine protection, we walk in God's divine provision, purpose, and everything else like that. And I think that's important, for us to be able to grasp a hold of that. Somebody need to point to yourself and say that the kingdom of God is within me. Amen. That is power. That means all the attributes of heaven is on the inside of you. That means anything that you have need of as a believer is within the confines of the kingdom. But the kingdom that we're talking about right now, since the kingdom of God is in you, everywhere you go, you are an extension of the kingdom.
So they'll see the kingdom manifestation through what we do as believers. Amen. Amen. when Nicodemus came to Jesus by night and he asked him a question about the kingdom, Jesus said, you must be born again. Amen. He said, you cannot even see the kingdom of God except you're born again. And that means being born from above. Amen. When we receive the Holy Spirit, amen, in us, that's the kingdom that comes to live within us. His Spirit, amen. And then that gives us access to everything that God has in that kingdom. We have access to it. But when we don't, when we're not taught or understand that everything that Jesus has in the kingdom is ours, then we don't access or expect anything, amen, amen. Because we don't really have a understanding that it's ours. But everything in the kingdom of God is ours as long as we're walking and we're seeking to please the Lord and in obedience. We can have what God says we can have, and we can be what he says we can be and do what he says we can do and the things that he's purposed for us to do. It's because he has put it in us. He has enabled us to be able to walk in the things of God because the kingdom of God is within us. Amen. That's why you can't look. He said, without observation, you can't look over there and say, there's the kingdom of God. Amen. Because the kingdom of God is within. Amen. But the manifestation of the kingdom has to be released through in and through us. People will see God's kingdom because of the manifestation of the works of God in and through us. Amen.
Amen. When we talk about seek ye first the kingdom of God, another way of saying this is tap in to the kingdom of God. Amen. Tap in to what you already have access to by inheritance.
Yes.
Tap into the kingdom of God. Oh God, I feel this tonight. Tap into to all the benefits of the kingdom of God. Scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All of these other things, what you shall eat, what you shall put on, all of these things will be added to you. Now, when we seek the kingdom of God, what are we seeking? We're seeking God's divine purpose for our life as well, because that's all in the kingdom. When we talk about God's divine purpose, another way of saying this is that we are accessing the will of God for our lives. Because the scripture says that if we seek ye first the kingdom of God, which is the will of God for every believer.
Amen.
All of your needs within the parameters of the kingdom will be added. So what is the will of God for your life? I think that's important that we want to activate that tonight, because you need to know that part of being in this kingdom is to being able to know the direction of God. Remember, the season that we was in has changed. God now wants people to have an intimate relationship where he can lead them. There's entirely too many people that are confused as to what the will of God is. And some of you have been saved for 10 years. Some of you have been saved a long time or have been in church for a long time and don't even have a clue what the will of God is for your life. What is your purpose? We know one thing, that as a believer, the kingdom of God resides near you, inside you. You have the ability to access it, which means nobody can hinder that. That's the beautiful thing about the New Testament believer. God has put it where you can have unlimited access to the rudiments of the kingdom, to all of the components of the kingdom, whether it's health, whether it's financial blessing, whether it's God's divine protection. Everything that you need is in the kingdom of God. And now remember, the kingdom of God is spiritual. That means in order to access the things of the kingdom, you have to come into the spirit realm. Now, remember we told you earlier that you need to pray without ceasing. Praying without ceasing brings you to the place where you can have continuous access to the presence of God, which opens up the wisdom of God. When you open up the wisdom of God, you get the direction of God. And you also get, and you also have a very powerful opportunity to walk in his presence. Oh my God, think about that. Then you can manifest signs, wonders, and miracles, but that's just part of it. Just think about being able to walk and talk with God.
Amen.
Things are happening right now where a lot of people, God wants them to hear the voice of God, and somebody's telling them and making them more confused. Confusion is not of God. Really, it's not.
He's not the author of confusion.
Amen. He's not the author of confusion. So you have to have access. That's a promise of Scripture. When you have the Spirit of God, you have access to the kingdom, which means you have access to all the private information, all the inside information that heaven has. Now, this is the thing. The information that God has concerning your personal life, and God can give you revelation about things that he's going to be doing in the earth in regards to you. That's when you start to graduate. Because as a part of kingdom, remember, when you deal with kingdom, you deal with territory. When we talk about the kingdom, it's talking about being an extension of the kingdom. That means we're always expanding. When God called you into the earth, he called you, in addition to winning souls, he called you to be an influence within the earth, to be an extension, to be a manifestation, to be a conqueror within the realm of the kingdom. That goes beyond the local four walls. Does everybody understand that? Remember, now, all of the scriptures of the church that Jesus said, I'm not talking about the ones all through the New Testament. The only time Jesus makes reference to the church in the recordings is in the book of Matthew, and that's in Matthew chapter 16 and Matthew chapter 18. Three times that Jesus even mentions the church. But this is the thing. The ecclesia is powerful within itself. But we understand by revelation, the ecclesia is not just the people in your local assembly, because many of you that know, there's some people in your church that are not even saved. They're not even born again. So the ecclesia goes beyond your local assembly. The ecclesia is people that belong different places. And God wants to send you in the workplace. God wants to send you in places of government. God wants to send you like what happened today in the shopping mall and stuff like that. The manifest the presence, but manifest the wisdom of God. There's people that are on this line that God wants to give you divine influence. Divine influence to be able to affect nations. Because when you understand the purpose of the kingdom, when you understand the purpose of the kingdom, God is interested in taking territories. Mm-hmm. Territories, mm-hmm. beloved. Amen. God wants to take territories. And don't think that you need the masses to do that. Amen. Because when you have the kingdom on the inside of you, you have the masses within itself. You have all the resources of heaven. You have all the power of heaven. So the kingdom of God is in you. So God is calling us to be an extension of that kingdom. God wants you to walk in. To be an extension of the kingdom, you can't do that without power. You cannot do that without demonstration. You cannot do that without divine wisdom and revelation. And I want you guys to pray that God will give you divine revelation and enlarge your capacity to be able to do more than what you've been doing. A kingdom person is always growing. A kingdom person is always being productive in the realm of the kingdom. So this is the things that we want to activate and unite. So as we go to Matthew chapter 16, let's tie this together. Hallelujah. I know we're going to give people an opportunity to expand on some things in a few minutes. And then we're going to take the time to, like I said, we'll just flow with the Holy Ghost tonight. All right. Matthew chapter 16, starting with verse number 13. Hallelujah. I just feel the presence of God. And anybody on the line tonight, we release the spirit of healing over you right now in the name of Jesus. We release that into the atmosphere right now. If you're dealing with any pains or discomfort or in any oppression, we come against any of that right now. We speak the blessing of God. We speak the delivering power of God. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost touch and consume everybody that's on the line right now in the name of Jesus. I feel the presence of God tonight. Oh my God, I feel this thing. I'm trying to be nice. All right. Amen. All right. Matthew chapter 16, starting at verse number 13. All right.
When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" And they said, "Some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." And he said unto them, But whom say ye that I am? Amen. And Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood had not revealed it unto thee, Amen. But my Father which is in heaven. Amen.
Keep on going.
And I say also unto thee, Thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Amen. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now, that there's a lot of meat actually in this scripture. Yes. There's a lot of meat in the scripture, and we would have to tackle that at another time. All right. But the gist of what we're saying is we want to go to verse number 19. Based upon the revelation that Peter received about Jesus being the Christ,
that was a revelation from the Father. Jesus is the rock.
And I say unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. Mm. We know the ecclesia is powerful. Amen. Based upon that revelation, that he's going to build his church, and the gates of hell should not prevail against it. What does that mean? Power. Mm-hmm. Power. It all goes back to that power against the powers of darkness.
Amen.
And then he says, I'll give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Here's that word kingdom again. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. We see a heavenly connection. We see ourselves as an extension of the kingdom here on earth. Heaven backs us. Now, that word key has a meaning. It's like the power to open and to shut. In biblical, use of the word is the power to open and to shut. And it basically means power and authority. Amen. Of various kinds.
Praise God.
And it means also the shutting a lot. So that means you can open and shut doors. That's power. Jesus gave us that type of dominion in the type of the earth. How many people do you know that operate in that? Really? No, listen. So that's not a knock, but I'm telling you what we want to do now. What we're doing tonight is we want to activate the awareness of just how powerful you are in Christ by inheritance.
Amen.
So we want you to be able to walk in these things, and we want you to be able to know your full access of authority. You have access. Now remember, you're dealing with the commander in chief. His name is Jesus.
Amen. Yes, that verse you kind of quoted it, but I want to quote the whole scripture. Okay.
Amen.
He said in John 1:13, he said, but as many as received him,
amen,
to them gave he power to become the sons of God.
Amen.
Even to them that believed on his name, amen, which were born not of blood, nor by the will of the flesh, nor by the will of man,
hallelujah,
but of God. Amen. That's by his spirit. Amen. We are born by the spirit of God. Not by the will of man, not by the flesh, not born of blood, but by his spirit. Amen.
Amen. That's powerful. I want you to feel this tonight. And when we eventually terminate everything for the night, I want you to get a greater hunger after God. I want God to reveal himself to you in a greater measure. I want you to alleviate any fears that you have. I want you to be able to know that you have a refuge, just like the illustration that we gave earlier with the umbrella. God is your refuge.
Amen.
But you need to know that by revelation. God is your protector. Hallelujah. So when we talked about also that whatsoever we shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, when we go to Matthew chapter 18, we see another illustration where Jesus uses that. But he ties it to two extra scriptures, verses 19 and 20. I'm going to read it for cause and effect. It says, verily I say unto you, whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, I say unto you, verse 19, that if two of you shall agree on earth, wow, as touching anything they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father, which is in heaven. That's powerful. And then it says, for where two or three, not two or 3,000, two or three are gathered together in my name, or as the scripture says, that can be translated in the character or authority, two or three gathered together in my name or my authority, there I am in the midst. Because a lot of people will say, well, we're talking about the Lord, we're talking about the Bible and stuff, so Jesus is in the midst. I beg to differ. Sometimes people are arguing about the Bible. And when Jesus is in the midst, something happens. Let's be real.
It's beautiful communion.
Beautiful communion.
Amen. We need revelation comes forth. Amen.
Amen.
Encouraging one another. Amen. Amen. It's uplifting. Amen. He's in the midst of that because it's peace.
It's peace. Mm-hmm. You need to know that the life of a believer is full of power. When Jesus is in the midst, there's his presence. If he's in the midst, he's coming. He's there. He's there in presence and in spirit. And stuff happens because Brenda and I have seen that.
We glorify him.
We glorify him.
The two come together, glorifying him. He is in the midst.
That's right. Because everything that come that every time people come together, they're not glorifying the Lord. So when you're glorifying the Lord, we understand that he's in the presence. And that's true in every setting. So when we understand the principle of kingdom and heaven itself, you don't need the multitudes. You just need the mighty. You just need the mighty. God in his infinite wisdom made it easy for stuff to move. Because trying to bring everybody together sometimes, quite honestly, can be a challenge. But you can bring two to three together and you can get a lot of stuff done. Oh my God, you can get a lot of stuff done, and we got scripture on that too. But listen, and we've seen the manifestation of the kingdom of God. Now, Jesus sent them out in twos in many times. Some cases they went out like once in a while, one, like Philip the evangelist and different things. But Jesus sent them out in twos. And you know, as husband and wife, my wife, she makes a powerful partner. So again, we've seen a lot of powerful things take place.
Amen.
The lifestyle of the supernatural is exciting. I feel this right now, and I want you to get excited too.
Amen.
Because everything that happens on these lines and these conference calls and the videos that we do on YouTube is to help bring you to a place where you start to walk in the spirit.
Amen.
Oh my God. My God, I'm trying to be nice here. Like I said, I'm relatively calm right now, but I'm feeling good right now in the spirit because God wants to elevate you tonight. We're going to give you an opportunity. If anybody has something that they want to add to this right now, we want to give you an opportunity to go ahead and speak up. Hallelujah. Because this is about as much participation. Again, as I say this, you're not under any pressure or any obligation. But if you feel the freedom to say something, if you have a prayer request, I mean, we want you to be able to release that tonight, and then we're going to move from there. Okay, anybody have anything they want to interject? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. All right. Hallelujah. If you think of something, then by all means, feel free to do that. So, this is the thing that you want to do tonight. Let me make sure that we got this thing on here. All right. We're connected good. Now, so we want to end any type of confusion that you have in regards to the will of God. The will of God is going to be paramount. It's going to be of great importance for you to walk in the will of God. In order for you to do that, you have to be able to hear what the Spirit is saying. Now, anything that we say prophetically is just simply to activate the voice of God on the inside of you. We want you to be able to hear from God, and we want you to be able to walk in revelation. Just like Peter got a revelation of who Jesus was, that was revelation by the Father. We know as kingdom believers, write this down. Kingdom believers grow and operate by revelation. When we talk about revelation, we're talking about revelation in regards to understanding of the Word of God, revelation about what we need to do when we go out in the world, in the three-dimensional world. That's got to be revealed. God's got to show you who to go to. Even the gifts of the Spirit are by way of supernatural revelation. Everything we do, even the Word that we preach is by revelation. Everything we do is by revelation of the Spirit. And as you grow and are sensitive to the things of spirit, that is a law within itself. Does everybody understand? Because remember, the Holy Spirit is the legislator of the law. The Holy Spirit is the one who wrote all of these books. So what you got to understand is that God wants you to be led. You got to look and understand that God wants you to walk in the spirit of liberty. There's too many people, even in today's church world, that are operating in bondage. And what we want to do is we want to eliminate that. Hallelujah. God bless you. Hallelujah. We want to set people free from the power of bondage. If you've been hearing from God, and you know that you've been hearing from God, and you've had somebody tell you that it is not from God, go back, make sure you know for sure. And that's fine. Because again, I went through a situation years ago where I came to something, where I came to my leaders years ago and told them that God was telling me something. They told me I lost my mind. And I went back and prayed some more. I went back and prayed some more. And eventually, I just had to do what I needed to do. But this is the thing. I'm going to tell you how dangerous this is. When I left the place that I was at that was not feeding me, I left and went. I had within a period of time before I physically moved my membership to where I was, I fell into a trance. And this trance had me walking out in this field, walking out in this place. And then all of a sudden, there was a wind and a storm was just trying to build up. And there was like this spaceship or space saucer or something that was up in the air. There was two trees that was out here in this field. One was a small tree and one was a big tree. I called myself moving somewhere close to the small tree. Lightning hit it and destroyed the tree. And then there was another tree. I ran towards that tree, the big tree, but I was afraid to settle there because of the turbulence that was going on. And whatever it was trying to pull me back towards the tree. That ended up being the place where God sent me, where I eventually got licensed and ordained to be an apostle. The big tree was that. It was a big tree. It was a big, strong tree. The tree that had been hit by lightning was the church that I was a part of. Within 6 to 8 months, I think it was 6 to 8 months after I left to join this other church, that church disbanded. They had a church split. And the church was broken up. That's powerful. God had warned me. And again, I had a friend that I was close to that we went through high school together. He stayed in that type of environment. And when the church split up, he was disillusioned. He didn't have any real church affiliation for a while after that because he put his trust in men too much. And he ended up getting himself, and he came in a situation where he ended up having brain cancer and different stuff like that, and he had to go through some stuff, but he had to be gently brought back into the things of God. The will of God is your protection. Amen. You need to be able to know the voice of God. If you don't know the voice of God, somebody else is going to tell you the voice of God. Now, it may be true that you may start out not knowing as a babe in Christ, but at some point you have to graduate and be able to know when God is talking to you.
And that's by staying before the Lord, staying in his presence, amen.
Amen.
So stay with God, stay in his presence, talk to him, tell him, ask him to talk to you, amen. He wants to have intimacy with you. He wants to be able to tell and direct you. That's what the Holy Spirit came to do, lead us and to guide us into all truth, amen.
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 You don't want to be confused today. You want to be able to know, oh God, I feel this tonight. God wants you to know him. Hallelujah.
It's about him.
Everything we do, because Brenda and I have gotten a t-shirt on a lot of things. There's people that have tried to put us into bondage, even with what we do. Now, this is the thing people don't understand, and this goes back to what I said before. When people say this thing about, and I'm going to address it again. When people say, who's your covering and stuff like that, you need to know what you're really saying. A covering has got to be walking first and foremost in the things of God. They got to be able to hear God. They can't just be controlling you. You got to know the difference between order and control. You need to know the difference. And like I told you earlier, I have people that speak into my life. Listen, I understand that. But what we've seen is such a spirit of control over people where people are confused. And at some point, you got to be able to know the voice of God for yourself. And particularly if you're going to be a leader, you cannot be like the blind leading the blind. We're here to activate something over each and every one of you tonight. And we pray that God give you a very powerful revelation of who he is and who you are in the kingdom of God. That's very important. God, remember, when you understand kingdom, it's about expansion. When you understand kingdom, it's about more than just your little few. God's going to bless you when you seek ye first the kingdom. There's lots of people right now, hallelujah, that are wondering why things are being held up. The scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things will be added. That means there is a will of God that blesses you. So when you understand, first of all, the will of God is seeking the kingdom. What is the kingdom? We know your purpose is involved. We know there's certain things that are involved in regards to the kingdom. And this, and listen, talking about the things of the kingdom is going to take more than one night. Really, it is. But the thing about it is, you want to get the mindset of knowing that you have access to these things. Once you understand that, if you know what the will of God is concerning the kingdom, you can rest. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. How do you answer the following question about covering? First and foremost, a person, if they're not walking in the things of God, we can eliminate that as a covering. Because a covering, just like with the umbrella is a place where you're covered in prayer, you're covered supernaturally. That's a divine thing where you're covered. Because remember, with the same context of the umbrella protects you because the elements are going to fall one way or the other. If you're under the umbrella, the rain is still falling. If you do not have the umbrella, rain is still falling. The difference is, without the umbrella, you're getting hit by everything, the sun and the rain. Now, the issue that I said in one segment about that is that there's people that are call themselves being covered, but they're still being hit by the rain and the sun. Why is that? Because there's holes in the umbrella. Now, this is the thing.
In the covering.
There's holes in the covering. There's vacancies in the covering, and there's a lot of holes in there, and they cannot properly cover you. Now, this is the thing. When you're properly aligned, then it goes beyond just the finances. You're talking about being fruitful in your purpose, being fruitful in your direction. You see the plan and purposes of God. Now, with that umbrella, hear me clearly, with that umbrella, there are times when people get attacked with things because they step out from under the umbrella. We understand that. In other words, in any ministry, there are people that step out from under the covering of God and the protection because they do stuff and walk in disobedience. So again, everything that happens to a person cannot be blamed on the umbrella. Because if you're under the umbrella, and this is the thing, if you can make a case if one or two people are getting attacked with stuff like that, you can make a case that might be disobedience. But what if it's multitudes in a particular place? What if you're in a place where a good portion of everybody in there is sick, or a portion of everybody is going through and struggling? You can't blame all of that on somebody else's disobedience. You cannot do that. You have to blame it on two things. Yes, ultimately, it is the person's responsibility to go where they need to go. But ultimately, if a person's a faithful church member, if they're breaking the door downs every Sunday to be someplace, if they're faithfully rendering their tithes to a place, according to scripture, there's certain things that should happen.
But it raises another question. Are they actually in the kingdom?
Exactly.
Are they under the divine covering of the kingdom of God, or are they setting up their own kingdom here on earth as a church and not as a kingdom, not under the umbrella of the kingdom of God?
Of the kingdom of God. I think that's important because many people, and Sister Rhonda, she brought this out, most times, and particularly this happens with ministers a lot, the first thing they want to know who you're connected to and who you're associated with. I mean, that is the pet phrase. Now, a lot of this stuff was orchestrated by the Church of God in Christ. A lot of this was orchestrated by them. That was part of their genre. Because I had to ask some questions about this. A lot of this was orchestrated by the Church of God in Christ. And there was teaching going back into the 90s in regards to this, and the 90s and in the early 2000s and stuff like that. This has been a big deal because I've had people ask me that dumb, stupid, asinine question. But I say it in that context because when you look at the scope of the people that ask you that and they tell you who they're covered with, you see a lot of things that are out of alignment in their ministries. I mean, they're out of alignment. And I have to be honest with you tonight. I have to go all the way live with you. There's things that are out of alignment. We go places where there are a lot of things that are out of alignment and they say that they're covered. So again, so when we deal with this, we have to get a balanced perspective. Let's be clear. If the man or woman of God, the ministry or the church doesn't have any power, they can't cover you. Their prayers are hitting the ceiling. They can't even pray themselves out of a paper bag. They can't cover you. And the thing about it is a lot of this stuff was orchestrated. There's people that are leaders and bishops that are supposed to be coverings that are dying of the coronavirus. How do you explain that? They're supposed to be coverings for people. What God told me is that he was going to start aligning people. During this season, he was going to start aligning people where they need to be. Divine connection is important, but some of this stuff is just ego tripping. There's lots of people that just want to be in control. They want to have somebody under them because we've seen that. And I'm just being real with you. Sometimes people just want somebody under them to feel important. This is what a true leader does. A true leader does the work of God. A true leader will do the work of God, and people will gravitate to that. You don't have to be begging people to follow you. You don't have to do that. That devil is alive tonight. You don't have to beg people to follow you. All this thing is about trying to feel good somebody's under you. And there's a pride and an ego with people. And this is one of the things that's just wrong with the seeker-friendly church is that people judge success based upon numbers, even if they have to inflate the numbers by people who are not born again. People who are not born again are not true disciples. That's potential, but they're not true disciples. And if they're not true disciples, you don't have any disciples. You have people there. And Brent and I, we've had a crack at that. Sometimes church folk can give you the biggest problems that there is. We've had some headaches with that. Seriously. So be careful what you're trying to get. You will get it. So people in the world, in the church world today, they want to know who you're covering to. But all of this was going on before the coronavirus. And we see that a lot of this doesn't hold water because many of the churches right now that are supposed to be coverings, some of them are shut down. And some of them, people are sick and dealing with things like that. So again, we're probably going to have to address this again. But it is what it is tonight. We want to make sure that at the end of the day.
And what happens if you can't get with your covering? Your covering, God is first your covering. Amen. God has set offices. He set apostles, prophets, teachers, evangelists. He set these things in the church. Amen. He has set up an order for us to abide under. But everything is not set up the way Christ has set his church to be set up. It's not set that way. And let's be honest, we're not set in an environment where we have all of these offices working in one church. Amen.
Amen.
So it's a lot of things that's not in order. A lot of things are out of order. So you have to know God for yourself. You have to have a relationship with God because you can't wait for somebody else to tell you everything. You need to know him. Hallelujah. You need to get your direction from God. Let's say we are put in a position where we're not meeting at all and don't even have Zoom or none of this stuff. Then what you going to do? Who you going to listen to? Who you going to hear? Who you going to talk to? Where you going to get your instructions from? You better know God. You better know him for yourself.
You better know God for yourself because there's many of you that before the coronavirus fell out. I want you to hear me tonight. There's some of you that have been through church hurt. And in the process of being through church hurt, sometimes you go through a transition where you leave from one place and you're still trying to figure out where you fit someplace else. Because sometimes people, it takes some time for people to know where they're supposed to go from. And then I'm going to say this, there's some people that are actually been saved long enough that they should already be in ministry. And I'm going to be honest with you, because when we deal with the learning curve of Jesus, Jesus took 3.5 years to get his disciples ready. I was teaching Bible study at 6 months of salvation. Seriously. I mean, so Jesus only took 3.5 years to get his disciples ready. There's people that have been saved for years that some of them should already be doing the work of the Lord. In God's timetable, it doesn't take long to mature. It really does not. When you're operating on the Holy Ghost teaching, all of this stuff where people are trying to keep you under wraps and say, well, I'm trying to protect the sheep. Some of that is not about protecting the sheep. It's trying to keep their ego from getting hurt. The devil, we have to be honest, you guys, tonight. You already know Apostle Young, and we're going to all be already live concerning this stuff like that. Some of this stuff is more about intimidation, because you got to understand that as we operate in the things of God, you got to understand, and we're getting ready to pray in a few minutes, as we get ready to operate, the Church of Jesus Christ operates in power. If there's no power, there is no gospel. That's the bottom line. If there's no power being demonstrated, the gospel is not being preached. The gospel of the kingdom has power. Hallelujah. So enough said for tonight. All right. We're going to lift up now. We're going to release you tonight. We're going to pray God's blessing over you tonight. Now, again, like I said, we want to seal this word tonight. I feel a breakthrough for somebody. I feel this right now. And we release that. Thank you, Lord, for the healing anointing that's going forth tonight. In the name of Jesus, we release. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for heaven on earth tonight. We thank you, Lord God, for covering your people. Give them a living, vibrant relationship with you. Thank you, Lord God, that you will confirm your word in them, oh God. We activate purpose. We activate destiny. We thank you, Lord God, for letting them see you in a different way. Cause them to be a true reflection of who you are. And Lord, bless those financially that walk in the supernatural, like you said. We thank you, oh God. I thank you, Lord God, for that anointing that's being released. Let the fire of your spirit burn up everything that is not like you. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we're in confusion tonight for somebody that's listening right now. Lord, lead them and guide them tonight in their direction. Let them feel your presence. Let them walk in the full manifestation of the kingdom. For the kingdom of God is on the inside of them. Thank you, Lord, that you unlocked revelation and the keys of the kingdom of God, that they will walk in that tonight. We seal this word powerfully tonight. And Lord, we thank you that you're divinely protecting them from sickness and disease. Amen. We thank you, Lord God, that they are divinely protected tonight from sickness and disease in the matchless name of Jesus. Somebody receive that tonight. Amen. Receive it in the name of Jesus. We declare that a done deal in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now, we get ready to close. Now, does anybody have anything to add before we close for tonight?
I do. I want to give a testimony.
All right, let's hear it.
Yes, all right. How are you? So good to see your faces.
All right. God bless you, woman of God. Oh, it's good to. All right. You know we found out.
Guys. Yes. So I just wanted to tell you that my ex-husband got retested for the coronavirus and it since came back negative.
Amen. Oh, Jesus.
Wow. And you know the situation and the circumstance, neither me nor one of my children have had any type of symptoms or sickness.
Well, praise God. Amen. Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. And that's the same way it has been. And I think,
amen. To God be the
glory.
That
is a blessing, woman of God. We are grateful tonight, because I'm going to tell you, and again, everybody that's been connected with us, like I said, we want you to know that God is a healer and stuff like that. And like I said, we've seen people get healed of the coronavirus, and we don't want anybody that's connected to us to have that. The devil is a lie.
Yeah.
We don't want nobody to have it. Listen, we don't want anybody to have it. But like I said, we want to make sure that we pray and we do our due diligence, because this is serious business. We have to stay on our faces before God. And like I said, this is a lifestyle. It has to be a lifestyle, woman of God. And for everybody that's listening out there, this has to be a lifestyle. Thank you for that woman of God. We appreciate that. Testimony. Oh, my God. Somebody give God a praise right now.
God, amen.
We give you the praise, oh God.
Hallelujah.
For the supernatural.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, we thank you tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
For what you've done.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you, Lord God, that Lord, for testimonies from this night tonight. We thank you, Lord, that, Lord, even as this segment is played over and over again, that testimonies will continue to come forth of your goodness and your grace.
Yeah.
We activate spiritual authority tonight in the matchless name of Jesus. We count it done. Amen and amen. God bless everybody that's on the line tonight. We will, again, the next time we will come together is Sunday. Now, this is the thing you got to take into consideration. We're going to be doing some extra videos during the course of the week. These videos are going to be extra teaching subjects that are going to be part of our ministerial focus because we want people to grow in ministry. We've got some videos that we've already done that are in YouTube channel vault, but we're going to release those that you can look at those and be blessed ministerial wise. Hallelujah. So again, as we send them to you, just take your time, digest them. If you get too many, just take them one at a time. There's no rush, but if you actually subscribe to the Ministerial Focus channel, you'll be able to access all of those anyway. All right, so I'll send you a video. And what happens is I think I've already sent a video to some of you. I gotta send it to the rest of you. But once you get it, just go ahead and subscribe to it. And then you can just access those videos. A lot of good stuff on there. We pray God's blessing. So again, we give you heaven on earth. You guys have a blessed night. We will be talking to you guys again real soon. We may talk to you sometime during the course of the next couple of days. But I think
Rhonda has something. Rhonda, do you have something?
Okay, Sister Rhonda, you got something?
I just wanted to...
We can't hear you.
I'm unmuted. Can't you hear me?
Okay, we can hear you muffled. Little, not muffled. We can hear you very, very slow.
Very low.
Very low.
Maximum volume.
Okay.
Let me see some.
Powering on.
Okay, try now.
Can anybody else hear me?
Okay, we can hear you a little bit now. Go ahead.
All right. Well, I just wanted to share that, and thank you, Brenda, for joining me yesterday. And thank you for all of your encouragement and what you shared with me. And last night I got on and I took the prayer request and I prayed. And I thank God because before I went to bed, I went back and I listened to Corey Ten Boom. I was like, she was there and it just came up in my spirit. So I listened to it. She read 1 Timothy chapter 2, those very verses. She read from John 17.
My goodness.
She said some of the very same things that I prayed. She said, she mentioned some of the very same things that I went through in the evening hour of prayer. Okay. And I just wanted to say that sometimes, you know, I know that God confirms his word. I don't worry anymore when I know God has told me to do something. Yeah. I don't worry about it. I don't worry who looks crazy and who don't show, because the Lord said, no matter what, you pray.
Amen.
And I thank God for that, because before I went to bed last night, and I've been all in it today. I've been just the last couple of days, I've just been listening and listening more and more. Like I told you, no TV, just the word. And I just, everyone I listen to, I'm hearing something else, the same thing. And I'm like, Lord, it's just so amazing how God does things. And I just thank God for the opportunity to be used. Amen. And I'm looking forward to him fulfilling his word to me from a few months ago when he said that he was taking me to a new level of intercession. Mm. I thank God for that opportunity. And I want to share that with everybody.
Amen.
God bless you.
Praise God. Amen. And I enjoyed too. Yesterday was a good prayer time, discussion, amen, in the word. Amen. And I hope to join you in the morning, 10:30 a.m.
All right, you guys. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. Thank God for that, Sister Rhonda. Thank you. We appreciate it. Eugene, Brother Eugene, you got anything to say, son?
No, not really. I'm just battling soreness in my ribs and back from a bad coughing spell, but I'm okay. I don't have anything to have.
Okay, well, we're going to take the time to pray right now, okay? All right, everybody, let's be in agreement for the man of God tonight, okay? Amen. In the name of Jesus, we declare right now healing across his whole body.
Yes.
We rebuke the spirit of infirmity over his body right now in the name of Jesus.
I'm against it right now.
We thank you, Lord God. No more pain. No more discomfort. We command this pain go and disappear in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for touching him from head to toe right now. Lord, let him feel your presence. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for moving in a very powerful and tangible way for the man of God tonight.
God, in your name, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
There were two or three. We can ask whatever we will according in your name, and we know it's according to your will. Amen. Healing is the children's bread. Amen. So, Father, we decree and declare healing over the man of God, Eugene, his ribs, hallelujah, everything come into alignment with the word of God. Body come into alignment right now in Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
hallelujah.
Name.
We Amen. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for your healing virtue that flows even now. Let the power, hallelujah, of the word of God bring healing to
Jesus.
His body in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you. We love you. Hallelujah.
You don't have to suffer in secret, honey. Just say, I need prayer. Amen.
We're not one of those people say, well, pray for me. If we can pray, then we'll pray.
We'll pray right then.
Mm-hmm. If we can, if it's possible, we'd like to be able to do this. In some cases, we can't. But like I said, we'd like to pray directly with people. We'd like to come in agreement with the word. Mm-hmm. So we want you guys.
You're quite welcome.
We want you guys to have a blessed night in the Holy Ghost. I'm going to be working on putting this thing together. I've been taking the time to edit these things, and I'll explain that in a private conversation. But you guys have a blessed night in the Holy Ghost, and we love you. We will talk to you guys real soon, okay?
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night. Thank you. Bye.